Looking forward to edit your photos in Zoner Studio, but you just don't know where everything is? Let's go take a look. Hello everyone, in this video we're gonna guide you through Zoner Studio, show you where everything is, and the essential things needed so that we can get started with editing our photographs. Let's go take a look. When you open the program for the very first time, it will start in the Develop module, where you'll probably do most of your editing. You'll see 5 pre-edited sample raw photos that you can use to test out the editing tools. On your next launch, the program will open in its default state, which is the Manager module, where you can start working with your own photos. At the very top, there's a tab bar that lets you open as many tabs as you like, similar to a web browser. Below that, you'll find the main menu, search bar, center panel, and the module switcher on the right. The main menu changes depending on the module that you're in. It adapts to the functions available in that particular module. Under the menu and search bar, you'll find the left panel called the Navigator. Here you can browse through your storage devices and folders, including the drives on your computer. You'll also see the Catalog, Zoner Photo Cloud, and Zonerama. With the Navigator, you can access any photo folder on your computer or connected drives. Another way to work more efficiently, and one that we definitely recommend, is to add your photos to the Catalog. The Catalog preloads all data so that your raw images will load a lot faster. You'll also gain more powerful ways to search through your photo collection. To add a folder, click the folder icon with a plus sign, choose your folder, and then click OK. Loading your photos into the Catalog might take a while, so it might not be a bad option to go out, maybe take some photos yourself, or make yourself some coffee or tea, and then come back once it's loaded. If you're interested about learning more about how the Catalog works, we prepared a video here, and you'll also find the link in the description. As you can see, you don't need to import photos to start working with them, even though the import button at the bottom of the left panel might suggest otherwise. The import is mainly used to simplify repeated photo transfers into your archive. It can sort, rename, and describe your files all in one step. At the center of the interface is the browser, showing thumbnails of your photos and videos. Everything here comes from the folder that you selected in the Navigator. Double-click a folder to open it, just like in a standard file browser. Double-clicking a photo opens it in a larger preview. Below that is the film strip with the navigation and toolbars just beneath the image. The right panel shows parameters and settings that change depending on which module you're currently using. Right now we're in the Manager module, and that's used to navigate through your photo collection, move and organize files, sort them, and assign different metadata that helps you find and choose your best shots. The Develop module is used for photo editing. Here you can perform almost any adjustment, from basic cropping, straightening, and exposure correction, to curve adjustments, retouching, and local edits with AI masks. And if you're not sure what a particular tool does, just hover your mouse over it. After a moment, a tooltip will appear with a description, and sometimes even a link to an article explaining how to use the tool. Next is the Editor module, which is meant for creative edits with layers. After that comes the Print module, where you can create photo books, wall art, print your images, and more. Yes, you heard that right. One big advantage of Zoner Studio is that you can not only edit your photos, but actually create something like a family photo book and even order it directly from the program. The last module is Video, which, as the name suggests, lets you edit video clips. We've also created separate videos for each of these modules and tools, and you'll find a link to that right here or in the video description. Zoner Studio is an ideal way to start editing photos. The entire interface and module layout are designed to be very intuitive. You start by organizing your photos in Manager, then make global and local adjustments in Develop. In Editor, you can add text or do more complex edits using layers. And in the Print module, you can easily place your photos into a photo book. And the Video module is a bonus. It lets you create a slideshow or short videos from your photos and videos. So that was a basic introduction to Zoner Studio. And if you haven't downloaded it yet, there's a link in the video description below where you can try it out for 7 days. And if you're curious about how to actually edit in Zoner Studio, there's a link right here that can help you with that. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you get started as soon as possible. Have a good one, and look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.